Let's look at how to calculate dollar value LIFO. The first thing we want to keep in mind is that this is a LIFO, last in, first out inventory method. And that means since we had the last cost, the first one's out in cost of goods sold, in inventory, we want to keep the earliest costs. So instead of tracking with dollar value, instead of tracking all the items of inventory item by item, they're pooling it together in dollars instead of items. And the challenge we have is as we look at the growth, the end of year prices, we can't just calculate how much it's grown from year to year by looking at these numbers because there's two components to the growth in inventory. One is inflation, represented by the price index here, and the other is how much the actual items have grown in inventory. So our first step is to deflate all these inventory amounts to their base year prices. So that just means to strip out the inflation piece. Since these are all percentages, when we do our formula here, when we deflate, we want to take the end of year price and divide it by the price index divided by 100. So in this case, it's essentially divided by 1, be 50,000. But as we just copy that down, you can see these are, so all of these represent our inventory at the base year cost. So we're comparing apples to apples now. We've taken out the inflation piece. So we can see what our real growth, or in some cases, like between these 2 years, our decrease in actual inventory dollars is. So the next thing we need to do is look at the change from year to year. Because remember, we want to keep the earliest costs. So we're going to calculate this year by year. We're going to begin with 2001. So our change from year to year, let's just do a column of change. This year it went up 5,000. This year it went up by 2,000. This year it went down by 2,000 from the year before. This year it went up by 5,000. And this year we went way down, 8,000 in real dollar terms. Okay, let's start with 2001. So since we want to take the earliest costs and our total needs to add up at base year prices, our total needs to add up to 55 because that's our total amount for 2001 at the base year prices. So our earliest costs though are from 2000. So we're going to keep all 50,000 of our earliest costs and the I'll save the price index for later. And then the rest are going to be from 2001. So we added another 5,000 in 2001. All right, so then we have to now, to get to ending inventory at LIFO cost, we have to reinflate to say what were the real costs for each of those layers. Well, for the first year, that price index was just 100. And for the second year, that price index was 104. And I just have a little formula in here that takes this number times the price index divided by 100 to give us our ending reinflated cost, so it's LIFO cost. So our actual LIFO cost for 2000X1 would have been 55,200. So we continue to follow that process for 2002. You notice up here we increased by 2000. So again, we want to keep all the earliest costs we can. So usually I'm looking up here at what those costs have been. So again, I'm going to start from the very base. 50,000, those are the earliest costs I can keep. From 2001, the most I can keep, because my layer is 5,000, so I'm going to do that. And then this year I added another 2,000 on. That gets me up. Okay, and somehow my formula here must have gone awry, because that is not, oh, well, the problem was that 55 to 61 is actually $6,000, not 2,000. Okay, so we went up 6,000 right here. Then my total, 61 equals 61. So now we're going to have to reinflate. Earliest cost, price index 100. Next year, 104. Next year was 110. Okay. So my ending inventory LIFO cost is 61,800. Now for 2003, interesting, our real dollar cost went down. So what does that mean? That means that during 2003, not only did we use up all the inventory that we purchased during that year, but we also ate into some of the inventory that we purchased in 2002. Okay, so let's go ahead, scroll down here a little bit, and start building from the base up. So I only need to get to 59,000. What are the earliest costs I can use? Well, 2,000. Use 50,000 from there. I have 5,000 in my layer from 2001. I can only go up to 59,000, so all I can do is take 4,000 from 2002, and then I've got to stop. I've got nothing from 2000X3. So when I am pricing this out, I use the price index for the relevant year. I am never going to have a layer for 2003. Because since my inventory went down, that means I used up everything I bought during this year. So that amount of 118, I've sold it all. I am never going to have anything that I can keep from 2003. Okay, so that then is our ending inventory at LIFO cost. Once again, we're reinflating each of these by the price index to come up with their actual year-end cost for that layer. Okay, so 2004, same process, although now we've gone up again. So we're still going to take the earliest cost we've got available, 50,000 from 2000, or 20X0, 5,000 from 20X1, 4,000, right, because we reduced the layer last time from 20X2. Oops, let's type that again. My 20X3, remember, I don't have a layer, so I cannot include anything from that layer. So for 20X4, that's where my growth is going to come from. The last 5,000 units, the 5,000 I grew, that was from this year's inventory. Okay. So once again, I'm going to use the relevant price indexes. I think we'll go a little faster here. Let's just copy these for these 5 years. And then again, with the formulas in here, it's reinflating to get to my new LIFO at cost for the ending inventory. So let's do this now once more with 2005. Notice once again our inventory went quite a bit down. So we're still going to start with the earliest cost we have available. So we're going to take that full 50,000 from 2000. We are going to take 5,000 from 2X1. But I can only go up to 56. That means I only have 1,000 left. In fact, let me scroll down to show that total at the bottom. So that this 4,000 layer, that means all I have left of that is 1,000. So once again, essentially what this is saying, the 56, is that I used up everything I purchased in this year. I even used up everything that I had left over that I purchased the year before that. And so I'm eating my way back through these LIFO layers. Okay, so that's my 56,000. I have nothing on any of these three layers. I'm going to go ahead and copy over the price indexes. Okay, so finally we're getting to 20X5. That is my final inventory number. The 56,300. Now, if we were to go on another year, 20X6, and inventory grew again, once again, we can never use any of these layers again because the inventory is gone from those. So we can use at a maximum these three, and then everything else, if it goes up again, the difference is going to have to be from the 20X6 year. Okay, so that's a little on dollar value LIFO.